This video is brought to you by Squarespace. League of Legends. It's pretty old, believe it or not. Since its release in 2009, a lot of things have changed over the years, and so here are 10 things only veteran League of Legends players will remember. Number 1. Unskilled players. Did you know there used to be an option to report someone for being an unskilled player? No, seriously. It was said that the original reason for having it was for Riot to figure out if something was wrong with their matchmaking system, but there's gotta be a better way to do that, right? I mean, I'm no genius, but if one dude's getting absolutely rolled by the other team, I'm pretty sure the stats will be enough to speak for itself. In reality, this report option was really turned into a mental self-esteem boost for all League of Legends players. Some dude a couple years back even made a petition to bring it back on change.org, but sadly, it's already closed. Number 2. League of Legends communication. Oh boy. These days, if somebody doesn't do the enemy missing ping when their laner is gone, it is all out chaos. You already know that your team is going to be flaming you nonstop until you're chatting more than you're actually playing. Well, back then, things were even worse. It wasn't until 9 years ago that Riot implemented smart pings, or what we know as the Wheel of Justice. Back then, there was no missing ping, so everything had to be communicated through chat. Does the phrase mid-SS sound familiar to any of you? Well, for all of you youngins out there, mid-SS doesn't mean mid no sums, but instead means mid is missing. You get it? Because missing has two S's and can also be... Okay. On top of that, it can also be abbreviated as mid switching sides. I mean, honestly, I don't know how people survived without pings. These days, I could spam ping missing in the middle of their screen and they still wouldn't back up. So for them to back up over chat, yeah, there's no way. Number 3. There is no Earth level. I'm sure just hearing that had to bring back some memories for at least some of you. You know how Fight Club's one rule is to not speak of Fight Club? Well, the same thing goes for there is no Earth level, or at least it used to. Back in the olden days, the League of Legends client sucked and would lock up a ton due to long queues and the servers just being down all the time. The League of Legends server wasn't as big as it is today, which meant it couldn't hold and sustain as many people. Also, the servers just kinda sucked. However, there was a secret code that only a handful of people knew called There Is No Earth Level. The code was said to originally have been created for Riot employees to hop on for testing, but clearly that didn't work out. Anyways, if you were to type in this phrase on the login screen and hit play, you would skip the entire queue of people waiting and be able to log into League even when you weren't supposed to.
Apparently, if you type in there is no Earth level into the client while the servers are unavailable or offline or in this case undefined, this happens. Yep, you can get back onto the servers.
This made for some very confused rioters sometimes, as random people would get on the server while they were working on it. It would be like skipping queue for ranked every time you started a new game, which would be extremely helpful for when my friends and I queue up for flex in a party of three because that freaking thing takes forever. I digress. The phrase itself was inspired by There Is No Cal Level, which is a reference to StarCraft and Diablo. It was rumored that Blizzard would hide secret cal levels in Diablo, and in StarCraft you could type it in and win the level automatically. Now, funny enough, this wasn't the only quote-unquote hack to help you bypass a long login queue. There's actually more of them, and one of them was the Konami code. Now, the Konami code is pretty dang well known overall in the gaming community, but what people don't know is that when you were on the login screen of League, you could actually punch in the code and it would sign in for you, or sign you in. For those who don't know, the Konami code is up, down, left, right, BA, start. Very well known. Here's a Wikipedia article. Riot even admitted to there being more codes or variations like these, but these were the ones we are aware of to this date. Number 4. Boots. Boots in League of Legends have evolved a ton over the years. These days, we can purchase all the way up to tier 2 boots, but back then, you could get up to tier 3 boots. Each of the tier 3 boots had different enchantments as well. Alacrity, Captain, Distortion, Furrer, Homeguard, and there was even a Teleport boot at one point. I'm not gonna get too much into these because I've already covered them in a different video, but what I really wanna highlight are the Ninja Tabbies. Ninja Tabbies, or what you would know as Steel Plate Caps today, were released all the way back at the beginning of 2009. However, have you ever wondered why the name Ninja Tabbies? I mean, I went years thinking this was a really weird name for boots. But it turns out when they were originally released, they had the ability to actually dodge things in game. So it was similar to Jax's E, but for your boots, which honestly makes so much more sense with the name because ninjas and dodging, you know? At one point, there was a 12% chance of dodging abilities with Ninja Tabbies. What's really sad is that this effect only lasts lasted for 3 patches, which means the majority of its life has just been Ninja Tabbies without the ninja. It's like naming your hamster Fluffy and then shaving all the hair off of it 3 days later. Like, come on, Riot. Number 5. Taunty. There used to be a bug in League where the game literally announced every single taunt that was done to jungle camps in all chat, and seeing how taunts were a pretty big part of some champions' kit, like say Rammus, it tended to happen a lot. After a taunt went off, the game simply said Taunty, and that was it. No more, no less, just Taunty. Over and over and over again. As far as I'm aware, this worked for champions like Ahri, Shen, Rammus, and even when Syndra used her W on a camp for some reason. It was later found out that Riot used global announcements on their internal servers like Taunty and just forgot to remove it before going live. Classic. Number 6. The Baron Pit. The League of Legends map has changed a lot over the year. I mean, it wasn't that long ago that alcoves didn't exist. Those came like 2 years ago. But one thing most people don't know is that the Baron Pit used to have a bush right in front of it. It would make for some very interesting Baron baits as your team could just sit there and wait for the other team to walk straight up into you. Also, apparently Mundo used to be able to solo Baron with just his cleaver. Number 7. Global Taunts. There's a point in time where sad robot Amumu's laugh used to be a global sound effect. Yes, I repeat, a global sound effect. Whenever and wherever you were on the map, you could hear that thing going off. Sure, you could mute your game sounds, but then you'd have no game sounds. So it just kind of sucked for everyone except for those who enjoyed making others suffer. Which, I mean, we're all League players here, so that's probably all of us. Nevertheless, these games probably felt really long. But hey, you know, it could have been worse. It could have been a lot worse. Number 8. Fortify. There's a bunch of different discontinued summoner spells out there, and one of those was called Fortify. Fortify was basically a thick shield that went over your turret, which made them invincible, and boosted their attack speed for 7 seconds, making it almost impossible to push against. There was even a whole strategy around it where your whole team would take Fortify, go top, and just ARAM up there. Except the other team couldn't do anything to your turret because you all had Fortify. If they went to a different lane, the team would just follow them there and then do the same thing. This sounds like straight up bullying to me. Number 9. Professional Blind Pick. Some professional League of Legends games used to be played in blind pick mode. Most notably has to be the Battle of Faker and Ryu. I mean, even people who don't play League still know what that clip is.
We have a man on the floor, I think he's in the bed. Oh, Faker may be in trouble here, Deathmark tries to clean it up for Ryu. Oh, look at the cleanse, look at the moves! Faker, what was that?
Still, somehow, a lot of people don't seem to notice that it's actually two Zeds fighting each other. You'd be surprised at the amount of people I've ran into who didn't pick up on that. But hey, I can't say much about it since it took me 2 years to figure out what AP meant. Everyone would just keep saying this AP thing, like, wow, their whole team is AP, and I'd be like, okay. Finally, number 10, Dancing Katarina. This is by far probably the most important one on the list. When you bought something on the old League of Legends client, you used to get a Dancing Katarina on your screen. Nowadays, you get nothing but the sadness of knowing you just dropped 20 bucks on a new skin. On that note, here are some honorable mentions. Everyone shat on EU servers, like gave them a lot of crap, which is fair in a sense because they kind of sucked. Gangplank's ultimate used to have an X in the middle, and it also sounded like a dying dog. You used to have the ability to ignite minions and monsters, which also meant jungling with ignite was a lot more meta. There's a small portion of time where Ivern used to be able to cover up Baron with his bushes. You used to be able to see everyone's individual ping on the loading screen, and everyone also had their own loading bars so you could easily tell who was on the toaster and make sure to shame them so they know how poor they were. It looks like Sexual Harassment Panda needs a new computer. There used to be mana potions just like health potions. And here's the old victory screen. Now, before we end the video, I want to talk to you about today's sponsor, Squarespace. Squarespace is an all-in-one platform and the place to go if you're looking to create a website. You may be saying, yeah, but who has the time to create an entire website for themselves? Well, now you do with the power of Squarespace. Whether it's for a business, a club, or for your selfish desires, Squarespace is the easiest and best place to get it done. Squarespace is ridiculously easy to use and has a ton of different features to help make creating your website as easy as possible while still being professional. Check out all of the different templates they have, all of which are customizable, by the way, so you can shape them into the perfect website for you. They even got a Squarespace Squarespace member area where you can connect with your members and create some member-only content. Spicy. You can add third-party extensions, easily keep track of webpage analytics, connect your social media accounts, and best of all, you can even purchase domains straight from Squarespace, which is extremely convenient. So make sure to go to squarespace.com for a free trial, and when you're ready to launch, go to squarespace.com/outsidejoke to save 10% off your first purchase of a website or domain. Thank you again, Squarespace, for sponsoring this video and supporting this channel. Anyways, what are some of your favorite nostalgic facts or memories of League of Legends? Make sure to throw them down in the comments, and as always, thanks for watching. Bye!